All right, this is at Coder Beginner Contest 174. Take a look at the first problem. Seems straightforward. Let's move on. Okay, again, seems pretty straightforward. All right, so far so good. I'm not sure how to do immediately. All seems to be being even or a multiple of 5 is bad, which makes sense. Because let me just try this. I'm not sure if this is right or not because of this number. It's wrong. Alright, math is hard. Okay, we need all the red stones to be left of all the white stones. Do you ever want to swap? Seem like you would. Oh, any two stones. So this is true. This is the condition. The point is that we're just going to brute force over this position, and then we need to count the number of bad stones to the left and the right. So all the white stones to the left are bad, and all the red stones to the right are bad. And the number of moves is just the max of the number of bad on the left and right. If we have something that's bad on the left and the right, we can swap them, and then neither of them are bad anymore. And otherwise, we can just change the color. So that's why the number of moves is the max. And so just try all the positions and, take the min of those maxes. Cool. Binary search. Yeah. That's not hard. Well, that's promising. Yeah, so the point is that we can binary search the answer. TLE, really. And once we have a candidate answer, we can test it by just subtracting off the maximum log allowed from each of the values that's too big. Oh, I see. The subtraction might take a while, I guess. Leave 0, can it? So it was too slow because I was subtracting instead of dividing. It turns out that division is repeated subtraction. It's a lot faster. Because k could be up to most a billion, and there probably are times when you actually use like roughly a billion operations, and so doing them one by one is too slow. Because we need to do those billion operations like log n times, something like that. If only I were good at data structures, I would be very confident about doing this. It's a very classic data structures problem. But I am not confident. Different colors. 2, 1, 2, 2, 6, 3, 3, 3. Okay. So the point is that every element, the first occurrence of every element counts, and the next occurrence, we keep track of what the next occurrence of each element is, so that it's as it slides out of the window, we can start counting its next occurrence, right? So the point is that we're sorting the queries by L. Right, so initially, like, all the queries are going to start at the left endpoint, and so only the first occurrence counts, because you know that you're going to see the first occurrence within the query, because it's starting at the left endpoint. And as those queries, as the left endpoint of those queries increase, you know that you're never going to see those elements again, and so the new, you know, you just chop them off the front, and then the new first element, the new first occurrence of each thing counts. And the way we do this quickly is that we can pre-compute every time we chop off an element, which, you know, there's going to be one element that's going to then count, which is the next occurrence of that color. So we can pre-compute that in basically linear time. And then when we're chopping off, right, this is chopping off the start element. So if it has a next occurrence of that color, then that thing starts counting. And then we can just treat it as like a normal Fenwick query. And because we sorted the queries, we need to answer them in the original order, so we need to keep track of that original index. And then answer them in, you know, the original order. Cool. Yeah. Find range problems tricky. I know the easiest way to do this online is, right? This is an example of online versus offline. Online is you have to answer the queries sort of as they come in. Offline means you get all the queries beforehand, so that we can like sort them. Does that really work? So that might be too slow. Anyway, we have solved all the problems, so that's nice, I guess. Not as fast as some people, but that's okay. So yeah, that was the contest.